I played with MJ on some exhibition, in some exhibition games at the Slits Malt Liquor Summer League in 1985. We played actually together for about 7 or 8 years, or maybe a little longer. We played on the Playboy team. It was a joy for me to play with him and to be a part of what was going on in the Summer League, because it wasn't just about b-ball. It was a cultural event, that Summer Pro League, that would be held every year, initially at Chicago State University, and then moved to Malcolm X and then to a couple other venues. But ordinarily, me and Mike would play on the same team. There were teams that were really good teams to play, but that Summer Pro League was where we would get together, and they had to have a whole nother level of security to get Mike in there. But he would come and play, because I think there's a part of him that is like pretty much any ball player or athlete or business person or just a common person that wants to compete. There are more people that remember those kind of times. And when I said initially it was a cultural event, it was cultural because generations of young people got to see that. There's a whole lot that didn't, but they got to see that level of play. And it was exciting. It was up and down. It was the things, all the things you can't always do on the professional level. But the creativity, just the awesomeness and the consistency of which players are going at each other, and the fans are going crazy. And I mean, the place is so packed that the floor is sweating, and I'm not exaggerating. I mean, it was sweating so bad that many of us at times had to sit down because it was dangerous to be out there on the floor. With the floor sweating with all those people in the building. So
playing in the Chicago Summer League, Chicago State was the best. I mean, it was wall to wall people. The walls would sweat in that gym, it was so hot. But the games were crazy. Michael Jordan, you have, Magic, a lot of Chicago people, Aguirre, Isaiah, Doc. So many guys came through, and it was some real basketball, and the fans were unbelievable. Full, just out the door full.
J.E. The chance to bomb it is your country club on my old summer league. Chicago Summer League. Says Summer League à Chicago. C'est un des meilleurs des États-Unis. On a joué contre lui là, bombé down. Je savais que c'était un bon joueur, mais bon. Mais j'ai vu, je crois que c'était Isaiah qui a, Thomas qui a donné un lob vers le vers Ono, et lui il a sauté là. Il avait sa tête sur le, en égal avec le sac. Et moi, non, j'étais pas en dessous, je n'ai pas pris, mais j'ai regardé quand même, j'ai dit putain, damn, man, that was wild. Donc, c'est ce qui m'a marqué le plus. C'est MJ, c'est qu'il était fundamentally sound. He had no weakness, aucune faiblesse dans son jeu.
I was going to play for the Coca-Cola team, and we were going to play Playboy. So when I got there, I was nervous, but I only saw Tyrone Corbin was the only pro at that time on Playboy. So I put on my uniform, and as I'm warming up, I can't tell you the order, but the pros start coming in. I believe Reggie Theus came in, who basically was one of my heroes growing up because he played for the Bulls. And the next guy to come in was Terry Cummins. So now it's getting interesting. You got Tyrone Corbin, Terry Cummins, and Reggie Theus. So now the crowd is coming in. And if you know anything about the Slits Malt Liquor Summer League, it was for free, but you had to get there early to get a seat. So I heard a buzz in the crowd maybe 10 minutes before the tip-off. And I looked up and I saw this little boy carrying a bag and some shoes. And then that's when the young Michael Jordan came in there, and the place erupted. And he was younger back then, so they were talking stuff. It was brash. real fun atmosphere. But the difference between the Chicago Pro-Am and most is that they play defense. So it's a real atmosphere. I watched a bounce pass from Reggie Theus to Michael Jordan from 30 feet out. The ball bounced. He dunked it. He started dunking on the whole gym. It was ridiculous. The game wasn't a blowout, but we knew Playboy was just too tough with Terry Cummins, Reggie Theus, Michael Jordan, and Tyrone Corbin. So again, we're playing, and then the game got out of hand. I mean, Michael probably had 60-something points, and he had dunked on the whole gym. So the funny story is I'm sitting there nervous and didn't want to go into the game, and the guy with 3 minutes left said, "Hey, young fella, big fella, you ready to go in?" And I looked at him right in the face and I said, "Nope. I don't want to go in there today." So that was the funniest thing, and I still remember it like it was yesterday.